Dear student, see last time in the lesson number 7 we obtained the solution of LCR-AC series circuit by using phasor method. Okay, that is a voltage and current relation in terms of phasor, and we also had a analytical solution. Now see, in the both method we saw that the impedance of RLC series circuit is given as R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Now see, our current IM is VM by Z. Okay, now see the possibility in which condition or in which case see the current in the circuit will be maximum. Okay, now see what is our variable. See, our value of R, L and C is fixed. See, omega L is XL and 1 upon omega C is XC. See, these three values are fixed in the circuit. So, only variable is omega, that is angular frequency, yeah, of the system. So, suppose we want to have the maximum current, we can vary the value of angular frequency such that, see this imaginary part of the impedance, see this XL minus XC shows the imaginary part. Okay, so when the imaginary part of the impedance become zero, that is XL minus XC is zero, that is XL become XC. So in that case, see XL and XC will become equal. See, this denominator will become minimum and the current will become maximum. So this is nothing but our series resonance. Sorry. Okay, when imaginary part of impedance become zero, then impedance of LCR series circuit become minimum and current in the circuit become maximum. This is called the series resonance. So when imaginary part of the impedance becomes zero, then the impedance of LCR series circuit become minimum and the current in the series circuit become maximum. This particular condition is called series resonance. Now we have to obtain the resonant angular frequency. Now here we have seen that XL is equal to XC. Let us say omega 0 is a resonant angular frequency. So we can write omega 0 L is equal to 1 upon omega 0 C. Omega 0 square LC is 1. Okay, so this omega 0 is the resonant angular frequency. Now omega is 2 pi f. Okay, that is known to us. So in that case, see, our resonance frequency f 0 is 1 upon root 5 LC. So this is a resonant angular frequency and this is a resonance frequency. So this is about resonance in the LCR series circuit. Now suppose we plot a graph. Okay, of current versus angular frequency. So in that case, see, this will be our omega 0 okay, and this will be the current. Okay, so the current will be when omega becomes omega zero, then current will be maximum. Okay, so this is a graph of current versus angular frequency, and in case of resonance, when omega approaches the omega zero, okay, the current will become maximum. Now, in that, as resonance Z is equal to R, why? Because the imaginary part has become zero, and current will be maximum. Okay, so this is the value of the impedance in the case of series resonance, that is Z is equal to R, and this is the current, maximum current will be Vm by R. Or sometimes you write Vp also, then also okay. So this is about the series resonance. So next we have to study about Q factor. Now see the sharpness of the resonance curve. Studied in terms of okay. Now this is a very important question, can be asked in theory for 3 marks. Okay, now see our equation Im will be Vm R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Okay, or it is now see recall our curve okay, this is Im max. Okay, now suppose I take two frequencies, see 1 upon root 2, see Im is, okay, let us say I want to show in terms of IRMS, okay, now 1 upon root 2 is 0.707, okay, now let us say this is the maximum current, that is Im upon root 2, now suppose I take 1 upon root 2 is 0.707%. Let us say this value is 100. See, and 70% of that. See, how will it become Im upon root 2 upon root 2? So, this will become Im. Let us say this line intersect the resonance angular frequency curve in two values. Let us say one is omega 1 and second is omega 2. Okay, one is omega 1 and second is omega 2. Now let us say this value, I say delta omega. This value is delta omega. Here delta is a small interval. Okay, now let us say omega 1, omega 0 plus delta omega. And here it will be 2. Okay, now this delta omega is called the bandwidth. Okay, this omega 1 minus omega 2. See what we can say, omega 0 plus delta omega minus see some of the book it is called half power bandwidth, but right now we'll stick to the word bandwidth. Now bandwidth basically is a difference of the frequency. Okay, see more regarding the bandwidth. Okay, you will study in lesson number 8, that is electromagnetic waves. But right now, we consider this 2 delta omega is called the bandwidth. Now, see, as I told, the sharpness of the resonance curves is studied in terms of the Q factor, that is a quantity which we are going to derive. Now, see, the Q factor is defined as okay, omega 0 upon Q factor Now omega 0 is our resonant frequency and 2 delta omega is our bandwidth. So Q factor formula is given by omega 0 upon 2 delta omega. Okay, so this is a called the Q factor, that is the sharpness of the resonance curve. Now see, we have to obtain this value in terms of L, C and R. Okay, now see, we have seen the current become 1 upon root 2 times, that is 0.707% of the maximum value. Okay, so now see our equation. Im is Vm upon R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C square. Okay, now at resonance, current become 1 upon root 2 times, that Im max upon root 2. Okay, so that is Vm upon root 2 R. Okay, now why? Because Im max is Vm upon R. Okay, now see, our impedance value is given as Z is equal to R square plus omega 1 L minus 1 of omega C. What is omega 1? See, omega 0 plus delta omega. See, let us say for omega 1 frequency, see, the impedance become like this, that is root 2 R. Okay, now suppose I have to solve this. See, if I take a square on both sides, okay, see, we have taken a square on both sides, so R square plus okay, so this will become R square is omega 1. Okay, now what is the value of okay, here also is a square, so R is equal to, now what is value of omega 1? Omega 1 is omega 0 plus delta omega. Okay, so that I substitute here. Okay, now see, suppose I want to take omega 0 L common. So what I do? Divide and multiply with omega 0. Okay, divide and multiply with the omega 0. So R is equal to, see our equation. Okay, so in that case, I can take omega 0 L common minus, here also omega 0. Okay, now see, R omega 0 L common, so this will become omega 0 upon omega 0 plus delta omega upon omega 0 minus 1 upon omega 0 C omega 0. Okay, see, instead of right hand side I have taken, okay, let us say R will be like this. Now in numerator I have omega 0 L, but in the second term I do not have. Now see, our resonant frequency omega 0 is 1 upon root L C. So omega 0 square, see, I split this omega 0 L I take in the left hand side and 1 omega 0 I take in the denominator. So what has become? See, this value 1 upon omega 0 C has become omega 0 L. So now my equation. 1 plus delta minus. See, this 1 upon omega 0 has become omega 0 L. Here, 1 plus R. Now, see, 1 upon x, we can write as x to the pi minus 1. See, at the same time, omega 0, if I take common from both sides, so it is omega 0 L 1 plus delta omega upon omega 0. Minus sign is there. This will come into the numerator. 1 plus delta omega upon omega 0 and minus 1 delta. Okay, now see, recall. See, our binomial expansion minus n power is 1 minus s. Okay, so this power will become multiplier. Here, this power will become multiplier. So, what is here? Omega 0, 1 plus delta omega upon omega 0 minus 1 minus delta omega upon omega 0. Is R. Okay, now see, this one will get cancelled. See, this is minus and minus will become plus. So omega 0 L delta omega upon omega 0 plus. Now let us see again. See, what I want to take omega 0 L common. Okay, so what I have done? Divide and multiply by omega 0. So our equation is like this. So omega 0 L is there already. Omega 0 upon omega 0 plus delta omega upon omega 0 minus 1 upon omega 0. See, I am writing together. Omega 1 omega 0 upon omega 0 plus delta omega upon omega 0. Now see our equation. Omega 0 square is 1 upon root LC. Omega 0 square is 1 by LC, we have done a square. See, this omega square I have split into two part. L will move to the left hand side and one of the omega 0 will move to the denominator. So this 1 upon omega 0 value I have obtained as omega 0 L. Now see, this 1 upon omega 0 C I have written as omega 0 L. Now see, we can take common omega 0 L from both term. Now 1 plus delta of omega upon omega 0 is there. Now see, 1 upon x will be x to the power minus 1. So when this term from the denominator moves to the numerator, that has become minus 1 power. So now see, 1 plus x to the power minus n will become 1 minus nx. Okay, so this power has become multiplier. Now this omega 0 L we have already taken common, 1 plus delta omega 0, this 1 will get cancelled. Why? See, the negative sign is there. Now this has become plus, so delta omega upon omega 0 plus delta omega 0 upon omega 0. So now I can write omega 0 L 2 delta omega R. Cancel. Okay, so 2 delta omega into L is R. Now see, our definition of Q factor is omega 0 upon 2 delta omega 0. So omega 0 upon, see, this 2 delta omega is R by L. So Q factor equation is this. This one is very important question. Now see, in terms of, see, there are three definitions we can see. See, the first one is this. Okay, second one, see, first, second equation, and the third one. See, what is our equation that we derived in terms of the series resonance? So if I substitute this Q factor, 1 upon root LC into L by R. Okay, L by R. Now this L in the numerator I can write as root n into root l. So one upon one of the root l will cancel. See, this will be the numerator. So this is our third formula. Okay, for q factor, that is under root l upon c into 1 upon r. Now see, the q factor is very important is in the tuning of electronic circuit. Okay, now see, in a tuning we can see r l c are present. See, when we are tuning a radio station, let us say your fm radio station or any other one. Okay, so when you are tuning the radio station, let us say 98.2 or 101.3. See, when we tune the radio station, you are tuning to a particular frequency. See, that frequency is transmitted by that the transmission tower. Okay, whatever the FM company, and your radio set is a receiver which receives this frequency. So sharpness of the resonance curve is determined quality called Q factor, and Q factor is very useful in tuning of the number of electronic circuit. See, when we'll have go into electronics or communication subject, so you will study in detail. So this is all about the series resonance and the Q factor. Now this is about the series resonance and the Q factor. See, next work we have to study about the power in AC circuit. Now see, in our DC circuit, power was I square R, okay, or VI or V square by R. Now see, here we are talking of the AC power. Series. Now this can be asked in a 2-mark question. Now let us say voltage supplied is 1/Vm sin ωt is a voltage supply. Let resulting or current I = Im. Now this formula we derived earlier. See, right now we write in terms of Y. Here in the notation, see, the capital I, as I told earlier, is the RMS current. Okay, now see, instantaneous power P = VI. See, this we can write as okay. Now I want to arrange in form 2 sin A sin B. So what I do? Divide and multiply by 2. So now see, our 2 sin X sin Y is cos A minus B minus cos. Okay, here I am writing in terms of X and Y. So this will become cos X minus Y. Okay, so we can write like this, VM. See, this will be our X and this will be Y. So X minus Y will become cos phi. Okay, cos minus phi. But cos is an even function, so we can write cos phi minus cos 2 omega t. Okay, now this is the instantaneous power. See, next we have to obtain average power. Here we have to obtain average power over one period time. So what we have used is, Vm sin omega t is a voltage supply. Im sin omega t plus phi is the current. Power is Vi. See, we have arranged in terms of equation 2 sin x sin y. Now See average power over one period of time. Okay. Okay, now these are all mathematic terms. We will not go in the proof of this. So you have to just accept that 1 upon t 0 to t cos phi dt is cos. Okay, and 1 upon t 0 to t cos. Okay, right now, no need to prove this mathematically. So our power equation has become Vm Im by 2 cos. See, this term has become 0. Now this is the equation of the power. Now see our Vm, this 2 I can write as root 2 into root 2. Now Vm upon root 2 is Vrms, okay, and Im upon root 2 is Irms. This is another equation you can write in this form or in this form. Now see, cos phi is called the power factor. Now recall our impedance triangle that we discussed earlier. Okay, cos phi we can see R by Z. Okay, Z is the impedance. Okay, and see our tan phi. Okay, so cos phi is R by Z, that is called the power factor, and the phase difference tan phi is XL minus XC by R, that is opposite upon adjacent. Now we have to discuss various cases. Now let us say AC circuit with only resistor. Now see our equation. See here, we have only R, XL 0, so tan phi. Okay, power factor is cos phi, cos 0. Is 1, so power is Vrms, cos phi is 1. Now AC circuit with only inductor, okay, now see, we have to remember our phasor triangle. Now here XL is there, XC is 0, R is 0, tan phi XL minus XC by R infinite, why denominator is 0, so phi is pi by 2, power factor is cos phi, cos pi by 2 is 0. So then if I substitute value, power is Vrms, Irms, cos phi. So for circuit with only inductor, cos phi has become 0, power is 0. Now see the third case, AC circuit, only capacitor, tan phi XL minus XC by R. Here XL is 0, R is 0, minus infinite. okay, that is also makes pi as pi by 2. cos pi by 2 is 0. So now again power Vrms, Irms, cos pi. Now here cos pi is cos pi by 2 is 0. So AC circuit with only capacitor also power is 0. Now we discussed earlier in the beginning of the lesson also ki when AC circuit with only inductor or only capacitor. See, even when the current flows in the circuit, numerical value of the power is 0. Though the current flows, numerical value of the power is 0. See, such a current is called the... So, we need to remember, wattless current is possible in only with circuit with L or only C. Now, these are the three different cases. One more case is a resonance. What will be the value of the power at resonance? So that will be our fourth case. See, at resonance, XL is equal to XC, tan phi. Tan 0 is 0, power factor cos phi, cos 0 is 1, so power will be Vrms. See, cos phi value is 1, okay, so power is equal to Vrms. So this is the value of the power in the AC circuit, series circuit at resonance. And naturally, when all three components are present, okay, tan phi or cos phi is R by Z. What is Z? Is the impedance. Or you can write XL minus XC depending on component. So cos phi okay. So this is the value of power factor, and by substituting the values we can obtain the value of the power in AC circuit with RLC only. So this is about the equation of the power in LCR series circuit. Now today we have discussed series resonance. We talked about Q factor, that is the sharpness of the resonance curve is given by the physical quantity called Q factor. We derived the equation for that, and finally we derived equation of power in LCR series circuit. See, next time we'll proceed further. Thank you.